वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. इट इज द सब टॉपिक ऑफ पार्ट बी दैट इज इंडियन इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन इंडिया, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज बेसिक फिजिकल एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल structure needed for the operation of the society or enterprise or reproductive system or the services and facilities necessary for an economy to function. It can be generally defined as a set of interconnected structural elements that provide network supporting the entire structure of the development. It is very important term for judging a country's or region's development. According to Keynes, the word infrastructure was exclusively used to describe public assets that facilitates production but not private assets of the same purpose. And also, infrastructure plays an important role in the economic development of a country. It can be quick or impede the development of the economy. Now, infrastructure in India. India is the fourth largest economy in the world, all of you are aware. However, one factor which is a drag on its development is the lack of world-class infrastructure. It estimates and suggests that the lack of proper infrastructure pulls down India's GDP by 1-2% every year. Physical infrastructure has a direct impact on the growth and overall development of the economy. And the fast growth of the Indian economy in recent years has placed increasing stress on physical infrastructure, such as electricity, railway, roads, ports, airports, irrigation, urban and rural water supply, and sanitation, all of which already suffer from a substantial deficit. According to Dr. Manmohan Singh, former Prime Minister of India, expanding investment in infrastructure can play an important counter-cyclical role. Projects and programs are to be revived in the area of infrastructure development. It including pure public private ownership partnerships to ensure that their implementation is expedited and don't suffer from the fund crunch. Now, what does infrastructure include? In infrastructure, there include different components. Communication is first, internet, mass media, mobile. Second is transportation, shipping, railway, airports and roads. Distribution networks is third. Fourth is financial institutions and markets, FDI, FII and banking. Energy supply system, in which there are petroleum, biogas, water, thermal, hydro, nuclear, solar, tidal and wind. But in class 12th, according to syllabus 2021, the energy in infrastructure is not included in your syllabus. That means we have to discuss only four components, that is communication, transport, distribution, financial institutions and health is there. Now, what are the factors which are required for better infrastructure? Out of them, the first one is there, that is general education, including related forms of classical, cultural, and science and technology, households, agriculture and industry. Third one is healthcare delivery system. These are the three required components of better infrastructure. And also there are two types of infrastructure, economic infrastructure and social infrastructure. Now, what is meant by economic infrastructure? It means infrastructure, those basic facilities and services which directly benefit the process of production and distribution of an economy. Like as irrigation, power, transport and communication are the examples of economic infrastructure. Second one is social infrastructure. Social infrastructure means those basic activities and services which, in addition to achieving certain social objectives, indirectly help various economic activities, like as education, health services, sanitation and water supply are the examples of social infrastructure. Now, why is infrastructure important for economic development? Infrastructure means now connectivity like roads, links, railways, ports and telecommunication. These are basic to economic development and growth. with connectivity the economy with open to outside world, trade and commerce with flourish. With connectivity, industries will be established as labor and capital will flow from surplus regions to connected and developing areas. Housing, education and health services also constitute part of infrastructure development which ensure improvement in quality of life. Next is investments by FDIs on India infrastructure. The Asian Development Bank ADB has approved $631 million loan to develop the first coastal corridor, namely as Vikshapatnam Chennai Industrial Corridor, which is expected to bring manufacturing and export industries to the East Coast. The Government of India has unveiled plans to invest $137 billion in its rail network over the next 5 years. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's aggressive approach to building infrastructure needs to unlock faster economic growth. Government initiatives towards growth of economic infrastructure. The Government of India is planning to boost regional connectivity by setting up 50 new airports over the next 3 years, out of which at least 10 would be operational in next year. The government plans to invest over more than Rs. 7,000 crore in financial year 2016-17 to develop its network in the northeastern regions for better connectivity. The SEBI, Security and Exchange Board of India, has announced norms and public issues of units of infrastructure investment trusts, INVITs, in order to facilitate infrastructure developers raise capital from public investors. The Government of India plans to award 100 highway projects under the public-private partnership, you can call it PPP, mode in 2016, with expectations that recent amendments in regulations would revive investor sentiments in PPP projects in the infrastructure sector. The Reserve Bank of India has notified 100% foreign direct investment, that is FDI, under automatic route in the construction of development sector. The new limit come effective from December 2014. Another concept which has been introduced by Government of India, that is creation of smart city. What is smart city? A smart city has three components: basic infrastructure, uses smart solutions to make infrastructure and services better, and relies on area based development. Objectives of smart city are based to provide basic infrastructure, quality of life, clean and sustainable development, apply smart solutions, set examples to be replicated both within and outside the smart city, and catalyze the creation of similar smart cities. Now the conclusion: India needs to urgently bridge the infrastructure gaps that industry and people face every year or every day. The slow pace of infrastructure development is quite evident from the list of 11th or 12th five-year plan that are unmet. MSMEs that provide employment to 60 million people in the country are the worst hit by the